Hi there, this is Rishabh, and I'm back with yet another episode of Behind the Codes. And joining us today is Mr. Manish Sharma. Manish has an extensive experience in information technology. He has been working as a technologist for years now. So there's a lot to learn from him. And let's get started. Hey, MS, how are you? Hey, Rajat.
Hey, RS. Hey, Rajat. I'm good. Thanks. How about you?
All good, MS. All good. So thanks a lot for joining us today. So I think we will follow the tradition and we will start by asking you, how has been your day so far?
So like Sunday is usual, family time, we can't go outside. So spending a time, quality time with family, and when my cousin visited us today, so his son and my son, and we all are, you can say, playing. So that's the way we usually spend our Sundays. So,
I think it's really great that you are joining us, like despite having guests at your house. So very much thankful to you for that. I mean, it's really appreciable. So Rajat, would you like to start?
Yeah. So hi, Manish. So hi. I would like to ask you how you end up becoming a developer. Like, would you like to share your journey with us?
Yeah. So after passing out of college, coding is my, you can say, during the college times, quite comfortable with the coding, and quite coding fascinates me, and we were quite. But during that time, after just passing out the college, my view was to become to join government jobs. So I started preparing for those. But immediately after the college, I started preparing for some of the examinations, but was not able to crack. Then I started preparing for higher studies. I go and prepared for GATE. So I qualified GATE, but due to score and rank, I couldn't have to make it like for NITs at least. So I dropped that idea. And after that, I joined one of the company here in Chandigarh and starting my career as a developer. So like, this is a 1 year gap in between these things happens. So after that 1 year, I started, and here right now I'm being a programmer, and journey is going on.
So Manish, main aapse ek cheez aur jana chahunga. Like, of course, this must have been an awesome journey. But jab aapne sabse pehli job ke liye jab apply kiya ya jab sabse pehli job start kiya, to how difficult it was for you to get that first job? Matlab usme aapko bahut zyada problem aayi ya wo experience aap share karenge hamare sath?
So after the graduation with 1 year gap, I and one of my friend, college friend, we used to stay together in Chandigarh, and we started searching for jobs. So I remember I gave around 20 or 22 interviews during that 3 months. And like, it's everything. Even RSI went to a BPO job as well during that time. The frustration was at peak, and after the college, we were not able to make the job. 1 year, almost 1 year was gone. So giving for iOS dev, giving for like Swift language was very prominent that time. So we gave the interviews for them, for other programming languages, even for testing, but not able to make. So finally, I gave a like 1 month break, brush up my skills. And then I again gave interview, and I think first or second interview I was able to make in that company.
Awesome. That's really wonderful.
Okay, so jo aapki pehli job thi, wo kis skill mein thi? I'm very curious to know, because you have given all interviews.
So I joined in the PHP, my first job, with JavaScript, and my interview was mainly based on that. And after that, like, it's a small company with 5 devs, and I joined with them. Yeah. Great. And yeah, that's the way, like, my if I would share, like, my journey started with 3,000 per month. So it's like a stipend based. So so like, you had, it's like better than not having like not a job. Yeah, I have still quite lucky that I got that job, and now I'm here. I'm very, very comfortable still.
Great. So, like, it's a long journey, very commendable journey, I would say. Starting with 3K, going up till a huge salary, I would say.
Yeah, that's a great journey. Yeah, lots of learning. Yeah.
Great. So, Manish, this buddy journey, I would call it a very awesome and great journey. So, this journey. पर आते आते आई बिलीव यू हैव बिकम अ प्रोफेशनल जिसे देखकर लोग इंस्पायर हो सकते हैं आज के टाइम पर. सो मैं ये जानना चाहूंगा दैट व्हाट आर दोस क्वालिटीज व्हिच यू थिंक हैव गोन इनटू मेकिंग दिस प्रोफेशनल. कि मतलब जैसे अगर आपको तीन क्वालिटीज बतानी है तो वो तीन क्वालिटीज क्या होंगी जिन्होंने आपको हेल्प किया ऐसे परसिस्ट करने में एंड टू कीप गोइंग.
सो बीइंग टेक्निकल एस्पेक्ट्स में भी मैं आई वुड से लाइक थ्री क्वालिटीज एंड बीइंग लाइक एटीट्यूड वाइज लाइक firstly, I would say like during my initial career, especially, I never say no to anything. Okay. Like for my like first 3-4 years, you know, I think it might happen to many of us. Like whenever we work with like small companies or anywhere, we got a people with positive mindset and negative mindset both. Mm-hmm. So somewhere say like, why you are working so late? Like it's 8 and you are still working because my module is not complete yet. That's why I'm working. So they were saying like you can do it tomorrow, day after tomorrow, anytime. But that's my I think first attitude due to which I got a great growth in my career is during my especially my initial careers, the learning phase I spent much time than required even. So that's the one way I built my career because I knew that and also I got many things on this from my father. That if you want to do something, just be hard worker, especially during initial years of your career. So like we are still doing hard work daily, but now it's like quite smart work, you can say. But during that times, we were not able to differentiate between the hard work and smart work. So that's the way you are keep going with the flow. And if you want to deliver this, you will deliver this. You stuck on one bug, it might goes for days and days. I hope you both can relate it quite well. So for those like we never like sometimes we was about to give up, but we take a break, then we again come back on that, then issue got resolved by luck, you can say. So those things we are always firstly that thing and being strong at my basics is the another thing which I think quite fueled up my career. So I always like starts with very basic. So if I would say I just want to know PHP, I go and start with the documentation officially and starts with quite basic. And those basic things, if I would go with advanced in the future, those basic things which I learned during my initial career is always fueled up. I follow this the same right now as well.
Great. So I really found this answer to be very honest, Rajat. Like, I mean, I have seen this a trend kind of a thing these days that we should learn to say no. But just like MS said, the practical reality may be slightly different, right? I mean, no is not always the answer. Of course, it may be the answer sometimes, but yeah. Yes. So like whosoever is watching this video, I think this can be a good point of wisdom for them that if you are in the initial years of career, no may not be the answer for you. Like you may actually maybe delete this word from your dictionary for let's say first 2 or 3 years, right, MS?
Yeah, because I believe whenever I say no, I just stop my path going ahead. So I just close that window in my initial career, especially now in order to do some things like I have planned 3 things in a day and it's absolutely necessary. And now I see the 4th thing, which I just rank at the 4th number based on the priorities. Then I can say fourth item, I can say no to that, but not for the first 3 at least. So that's right now my approach. But initially, during initial careers, I always say yes to each and everything because the learning curve which I got during that time is quite quite. I thought during at that time is absolutely necessary for me.
Great. So and now MS, that you're at a position where you can actually hire others also, and you do that. So what are those qualities which you look for in those people who you're hiring?
So if I would rank based on the experience, I would just whenever I check the resume, I just make a picture of the person, that what should that person should know about at least. So like I always look for basics, not advanced concepts. Like firstly, main three pillars in my like basic programming language, his very basic things. Second is his logics, that how he can, if I would say I give him a like prime number program, let's say, so he should be able to at least tell me the logic that I'm going to do this and this. So not exactly, if he not able to write the program, I think that's okay during the initial years, but at least the programmer or any developer should be able to tell the logic. Or if I would say any series he wants to print with the arithmetic expressions, then he should be able to do that. In my view, this is number two. And number three is like OOPS concept. It's like you can say backbone of a programmer, like object oriented programming, which we studied in the second, third year of our graduations as well. So I believe OOPS is also a thing, like basic concept should be aware of with that. And most important, like attitude. If I would say he was not able to, for example, he was not able to write a program, then I would say, if you are like, can I move further? Then if he just stop that and yes, go ahead with the another, then it shows that he's not keen to solve the problem right now in the hand. But sometimes I see the candidates who are eager to solve that. Maybe he will not able to, but still that his or her attitude is quite important to see whether they can cop up with the trendmark, like the trending things we do every day, or any bugs we solve. So what type of attitude that person is carrying is also important.
So it's like, even if the candidate is not able to solve the problem, but he's curious enough, or he is showing interest, or the zeal towards getting the solution, right?
Yes. In top of that, RS, I just want to add, like, there are two things, like skill and will. So skill can be worked upon. Anyone can teach us, or even we can teach ourselves. But will is the most important thing, which always helps us.
Awesome. Yes, I guess it's very beautifully compiled by Manish, that like skill can be learned, but will, you have to have it within you. Right. Okay, so do you remember any interesting stories like which happened during your career, like which is like something funny which happened? Would you like to share that with us?
Something funny, like I just related with programming. During my previous organization, I used to work on one module. I think if I would explain it, it becomes a bit technical. But for example, we want to give some code base to the third one organization, and that organization needs to install that piece of software on their machine. So, but I write a script which usually transfer all the files to that zip file to their respective locations in the in that company's servers. So we don't have access to that. We just need to provide them a zip and one scripting file which actually transfer the data there. So I did I remember I took a 4 days of time in order to develop that, and I got that, and it's like last day of my unit testing. And what I did, but bad thing I did, I didn't commit that file to versioning control that time. Okay. And when I run the script, by accidentally, while moving the files in the zip, in the code, I actually deleted the file where I write the code. So it's like, if practically I would say, it's like on which branch I'm sitting, I just cut that branch. Yeah. So I just fell down off. And I remember I took Saturdays and Sundays, like 2 days, because code is all in our mind at that time. So that four and a half day of work, I took Saturday and Sunday, and I fixed that. And then after, we were able to deliver that on Monday. So that's some funny thing.
That was interesting experience.
On what Manish shared, I just remembered an incident that happened to me during my initial stage of my career. So I once like corrupted the production database. I was not aware of it, and they gave me the access, so I corrupted it, like not voluntarily, but it happened. And then from that time onwards, I'm always afraid of like playing with production.
Yes, obviously. That one thing reminds me of that. One time we took a backup and of the production during our initial careers, we were not able to the backup and file is gone. So now on production, file is not there and you don't have a backup. It's like nightmare for you if it happens around 10 p.m. in the night or 11 p.m. So you can't sleep well on that night for sure. So yes. So this do happen, but now it's not happening because we always took a step. And we always take a backup before going forward.
Yes, like coding standards are actually improved a lot currently, because I remember in like 2015-16 when I started my career, I was not like in my personal coding style, I was not that much into versioning and all. And I remember having multiple folders, like this is a version one folder, version two, second folder and all in my system only. And sometimes what used to happen, like I'm running it from version 2 and I'm doing the changes in version 1 on my system only, and then crying for half a day that my code is not working, like the changes are not getting reflected, and these kind of things, they used to happen a lot during the initial stage. So
yeah right
reminded me. Okay, yeah. Yeah. Over to you, Rishabh.
Cool. Yeah. So, Manish, how do you see software development as a career now that you have a very mature career? Like, what are your thoughts about software development as a career?
So, in my view, software development is having a bright career, if I would say, for the next 10-15 years. Not sure beyond that, but like it's like the way at the time we have started. I remember when I joined the college recently, Satyam scam was happened. Yeah. And we, as a computer science graduates, we were thinking that if that is the case, even we don't have that much knowledge that what actually happened with the Satyam and what happened during that time. So we thought that how our career will end up, whether we will able to make it. We heard that campus interviews happens, but whether we would able to make it or not. So during that time, and if I would say now, it seems like 180 degree thinking changed, or obviously it do happen with all of us, I guess, that whatever we are thinking 3-4 years back, right now we are slightly different, and we usually laugh on the thinking of which we usually have at that time. So in my view, for the, if anyone new graduates or new computer science person watching this, then I think software developer is no doubt having a great career. It all depends on your will, that how you want to brush up your skills and where do you want to go. So it's like you can go anywhere you want. It's like a whole forest is available to you. It's like how you want to crack that out.
Exactly. So there is one more thing, like Manish, you really compiled it very well, but I would like you to specifically talk about the amount of patience and persistence which is required when you want to build a career in software development.
Patience and persistence. So I think in my view, RS, firstly, whenever we are a fresher, that I think we. So I would like to add one thing here, RS. Like, firstly, in order to build a good career or stable career, I think one should choose a mentor.
Of course.
So choose a mentor that you can see off. Like I want to learn from him, and if I would be him, then I would be at very much happier state. So like choose your mentor, because only this is the like most I would say the shortcut way to build a stable career. Like you can learn from his mistakes, mm-hmm. You can learn from his wisdom, that how you can build your career, what things you should avoid and what things you could. I think by knowing that person a mentor knowing you personally could judge you well, that where you are lagging, where you have a strong grip, they can easily evaluate between you and guide you through that you should avoid this and you should try this. So in that way, you can follow him in the initial career, I think, not blindly exactly, but what you think is right. If you see improvements by following his tips or her tips, then you can say that you are going on a right path. If If not, then you should revise or you should rethink that where it went wrong and where. So I think number one is choosing a mentor. And number two is like, whatever you do, if you know how the internal things work, it also helps you a lot for your stable career. Because if you were not able to explain to anyone in like one or two sentences, then it might be that you are not knowing that thing up to that extent where you should be. So in my view, knowing the thing internally, that how compiler works, how it's parsing the tokens, and if I write this, how that interpreted in the output. So it's like a basic programming thing. If you know internal of that, you should be able to tell compiler, no, don't want to do this, write this. And correct. I think in terms of patience, before writing a code, write it over the piece of paper and see how you can refactor it, then put it in a machine. I think that's also help you in order to improve your skills more effectively.
Right. So Manish, you really brought this topic that having a mentor early in the career is very important. Well, on the same line, I would like to ask, how do you see the importance of having, let's say, your peers or those who are of your age on the same journey with you? So like, what kind of impact can they have on your career?
So in my view, my peers, my friends, you can say, or my colleagues, you can say, they are obviously having a positive impact. And like I previously mentioned as well, Aras and Rajat, that choose the persons in your life quite with a proper analysis. Like if you see someone is pulling negativity out of you, then I think you should avoid that person. If someone is bringing positivity and push you up, and he's always happy, if you got something, if you got appreciation, for let's take a very basic example. If you got appreciation from a client and everyone in your team or outside of the team appreciates your work, and that person is, you see that actually happy is with you, then I think that's the person you can stay with, because he knows if you grow, he also grows at some sense with them as well. So that's I think, so peers obviously help you positively if you choose your peers wisely. Cool. Yeah, this reminds me of latest series, RS, the TVF, I think Aspirants is the series. So yeah, I think everyone should have the SK like friend who always appreciates you. So I think if no one watched it, just go and watch it and you will get to know.
That's a good suggestion. To be honest, I have not watched it, but now that you have suggested, I would definitely give it a thought.
Must watch, I guess.
So yeah, I completely agree with what Manish just said, that peers does have an impact on us. Like, I would like to add something here. So before the corona thing, like BC, before corona, okay, yeah. So before corona, I was not interacting with my peers as that much, like in terms of like other than office, we were not that much in touch. But during the corona days, we all were like very much like missing each other and getting bored. So we started this talk on every Friday after office. So we used to get together and just talk about how our weekend went, and suddenly it started as a very non-technical conversations. It started off like that, but eventually it turned out to be, we used to talk about how we can grow, what are the things we should learn, and suddenly it became like a very informative session for me. So yeah, like having peers and having these kind of conversations with them, we should always initiate in our career, because that's going to take us a long way.
Yeah, be social is the one of that, right? Just yes. Socialize with the other persons and try to grab positive things from him. If anything negative you see, try to exclude that from that list.
So yeah, great, Manish. So Manish, you have seen this transition from being a developer to a senior developer to a tech lead. Now, like being a lead is a different position in itself. Like you have to actually lead people, right? So like my first point will be, how do you see it as a different role, right? And then we will talk about the challenges which come with this role. Because with great power comes great responsibility, of course.
Obviously, yeah. So, Aras, in my previous company, I used to be joined as a dev. Then I become a senior dev as well as the team lead over there as well. Mm-hmm. And again, when I switched my previous organization and the current one, I again joined as a senior dev, then also got promoted within a 2 years to tech lead. So it's like a bit ups and downs of journey in my career. Like firstly, I become a senior dev, then tech lead, then team lead, then again to the senior dev again, and then again to the tech lead. So like I experienced both ways like twice in my career. So I can relate. So based on that, I would say every role is challenging if it's terms of the work and what you want to deliver. But as you go higher in the hierarchy, you got great responsibilities and expectations, obviously, from your upper hierarchy becomes higher and higher. So if I would say senior dev could expect something from junior dev, and same tech lead could expect many things from senior, as I go, my manager expects with me from different level of expectation. So like so being a dev, you just need to do a code, just do an understanding of the requirements and get a guidance from your seniors. But as soon as you go to the tech lead position, I guess you will get to the more in the state that you need to mentor someone, and you also need to become a example to someone, so that they are saying that he is a lead, he deserved that, and we should follow that. Because unless if you don't feel in yourself that you are not you can't be in that role, or it's a negative role, or it's like more responsibilities, and you can't see your subordinates in that, then positively, you need to see your subordinates positively. Then I guess it's like going forward. If I would go upper in the hierarchy in the future, then obviously being I need to see more subordinates positively, and need to mentor those and guide those whatever skills I do have, and obviously learn from those as well. So learning from your subordinates, when comes it learning? Don't see who gives you a teaching. It's like your mentors could be one, your peer could be one, your subordinate could be one. So never relate that learning with the position of the person. But it comes off your daily job. Then you can obviously mentor or give your instructions to someone. Then I think that in that way your lead position would get defined. So I think that helps answer the question.
Really, and I mean it definitely does. And what are some of the challenges which have come up with this position? Like the challenges which you didn't see when you were a developer, but as soon as you become a lead, what were those challenges which were new to you, like where you actually had to face some kind of difficulty to get past them?
One challenge, I would say, I can't say challenge, but the one thing is like, while I become a lead, I usually don't see the clock, but as soon as I see it, it already becomes 5. So time passes like this. So that's the one thing. While I was dev, I used to think I can see the clock once or twice, like it's lunchtime. Yeah, it's lunchtime. So and you have penalty of time to in order to work on your skills as well as on your current project. But being a lead, you got with the more responsibility. So day is gone like anything. So this is the one. I would say other than that, with the the one thing is handling a team, handling a project, giving a technical solutions, all these things I would say comes daily with the new challenges. So the problem you are facing right now might not be the same problem you are facing after a week. So it's like keep on changing. You must need to adapt yourself, and your team needs to be adapt accordingly. You need to navigate the whole team with you and the whole project you need to deliver in a way. So as you have a small boat, I would say, boat which you are carrying with your own hands, and it's your decision that how you want to drive that boat. So like you are a driver of that. So I would say in that way.
Yeah. And let's say, what would be your kind of a message or any kind of experience which you would like to share with those developers who are actually willing to or planning to or actually preparing to become a tech lead in the coming times? So what would be your wisdom which you would like to share with them, which can actually help them be more effective with their responsibilities in this new role?
Yeah. So in my view, if I would say any developers who are looking for senior roles or any senior roles who are looking for technical leads, in my view, that firstly, just see what, like there's one thing, like this is my KRA, like key responsibilities areas where I just need to see that this is my view and I only need to see. Just always try to think beyond that. So like if this is my area, my work area, I can't go beyond that because this is not my area of job. If some your peer, like if I'm a, you can say I'm a junior dev and another junior dev facing an issue and you have obviously a time, then don't see your senior or tech lead to see and support him. If he is, you can discuss with your lead and should I try and discuss that issue with my another junior dev. So it's like you are expanding your area. So keep thinking in that way. And you don't even realize that now you have already gone to upper in the hierarchy. So always try to support others. Because knowledge you share, it will always increase whenever you share. You got something from others. So keep adding that to your stack. And surely, in my view, that will help in the person. Like it's a quite basic, but I think many people ignore that.
That's a wonderful answer. Yes,
okay. Yeah, even I would like to add, so any person who's like in a junior position right now and who wants to move up the hierarchy, please stop thinking that tech leads don't work and management people don't work, because they do a lot. that's the first thing which you have to do.
I think, yeah, that would be a misconception to think that your pressure is ever going to reduce. Because I think it's actually the other end of the spectrum. It's actually going to increase a lot.
Yeah. Yes. We can't judge others like they are doing. Just see yourself what you are going to do. It's, I think, important.
Great. I mean, like, why blame others? Even when I was in junior positions, I used to think that my tech lead, he just assigns me work. What is he doing?
It happens. Yeah. Even we used to think that in that way.
Yeah.
It do happens. Yeah.
So only when you taste that medicine, you get to know.
Yes.
Cool. Great.
Exactly. Yep,
okay. So keeping this technical stuff aside, so Manish, what are your hobbies? Like, except like if I don't see you coding or like managing your subordinates, what can I find you doing?
My hobbies. Is like firstly by heart since my school, I'm a magician. So I used to in my school time I used to play a piano during my prayer times, and after that after my degree it got a bit sideways, but after that I started again. So I love to play music instruments. I'm learning a lot those, so I keep growing in that in a quite slow pace, but yeah, I'm doing that one. So, and others like reading is my bit habit, which sometimes I start quite nicely, sometimes got due to some other priorities, obviously. So I got a bit delayed on that, but like reading, I keep on reading whenever I get a chance.
So, and there is an interesting thing about Manish, which I know, that he keeps on experimenting with new musical instruments. So Manish, would you like to share something around that hobby of yours?
Yeah, recently I'm trying to learn flute. So it's a new thing which we are trying, near around lockdown or after that, I used to. So I started. So blowing up a flute is the most, you can say, the first step is quite hard in the fluting. I have covered that and now learning songs. So yeah, that's the one.
That's really nice, because I think that requires a lot of focus and a lot of concentration to be able to, as you mentioned, the first step is very difficult whenever you're learning a new musical instrument.
Yes, right. Yes,
sir. And what have been some of your favorite books, Manish?
Favorite books, like I recently read Wings of Fire by Kalam sir. So I think that's quite an inspiring book. A must read book, I guess, if you have not read it yet. And yeah. The one I think the previous session one also talk about that is Rich Dad Poor Dad. That is also one quite eye opener, if I would say, for me at least. So I think these are the two books I would say.
Great. And maybe coming back to the tech side again, what are some of the tools which you end up using in your everyday life? Like which actually make your life slightly easier in whatever role you are playing. So it could be like as a developer also, as a tech lead also.
So it's like the tools which I use day to day life. Are you saying about that, right?
Yeah.
Okay, like the editor, VS Code editor is like quite favorite one which we use. I know and I can relate with that many devs or many new developers starts their career with Notepad++, I think, but that's realized after some time that's not a good thing. If we need to develop a good project, we must need some good editor like NetBeans or VS Code. So VS Code is my favorite one. We can install various extensions in that, like Sonarlint, which is also getting a quality code, or you can say showing you your error that you are doing this loop too many times, or these conditions are getting nested in too many ways. So you can optimize that in a way straight away in the editor without pushing that code in the versioning control. So VS Code is the one tool. So other than that, I guess the normal our Jira tool, Atlassian Jira is the one where we are managing our project. It's quite effective tool. Sometime it got a bit slow, but it usually become very, very handy and quite comfortable tool to in order to communication between the teams, MS Teams, Slack. Slack is the one, obviously, so many features in Slack. Still, I'm exploring that. You can set reminders, anything. So it can be your single tool where you can manage each of your to-dos, your reminders, and everything. So that's the one.
Awesome.
Okay. So, Manish, what would you prefer? Like knowing one tech from like top to bottom, or like becoming a master of one tech, or like knowing many techs? Like, what would you prefer? Like, am I able to clear my question, Rishabh?
Yes, like I got that. Okay. I even heard that on your previous episodes as well. So that's concept is like, in my view, I think how I would relate this is that everyone should be, there are two types of learning, and right? Like horizontal learning and vertical learning. So horizontal means you are knowing something of Node.js, something of Python, something of Java, something of PHP, something of like, and vertical is you know this thing and you know ins and outs of everything of that. So I think in my view the answer should be both, but I can relate that with the example of traveling. I used to travel so much before COVID BC. So the one thing is like you should go and travel everywhere you want. Like just see you can go anywhere you want. You should go. You should just experience that and just come and know that and experience that feel. You can go to, for example, let's say you can go to Rishikesh, you can go to South India, you can go to Northeast, you can go to, let's talk about India only. So you just go anywhere and realize that. But one thing, or you can say just follow one path of the traveling where touches you the most, where you are experiencing the most, let's say hills fascinating me. So I always, whenever I go to hills, I just go and I just lost there. So I'm not I when I'm I am having in just staying in the hills. So that's one thing that fascinating me. So I need to go to those hills each and every time, and I can explore that. I know ins and out of those. So that is the one. So go everywhere, learn everything. You know the basic, because that basic things will always help you in order to understand that depth thing which you are understanding. So just know, so for example, you want to explore Python. Just go dig Python and explore everything. And you get to know that one thing Node.js is doing. You know very basic of that in that way. So by knowing that Node.js is doing something like this, how can I do that in Python? So you even get to know more detail in the Python. So I think that's always supports each other. But knowing one thing deeply, I think should be the priority. But other things you can't, you can have a basic knowledge of it, because this in one single life, no one can know everything.
That's correct. I think this is a very beautiful answer. I mean, it's like saying that only when you will travel other places, you will get to know whether you like them or not. But as Manish mentioned that, but if you know, like when you know that, okay, I like mountains or I like beaches, then you have that control to decide whether I want to, let's say, spend more time at beaches or whether I want to spend more time like at mountains. So that's a very beautiful answer, Manish. Thanks so much for sharing this answer. Great. And Rajat, any other points from your side?
I would like to say I completely agree with what Manish said. Like, we need to, like, the travel part needs to remain same. Like, we can relate it to tech also.
Mm-hmm.
That you need to learn how to travel. Where you are going doesn't matter much. Like, it differs from person to person, but we should know how to travel.
Correct.
So, yeah, beautiful answer.
Great. So in the end, Manish, we would like to know that if you have to give a message to those who are actually starting on this path, let's say we're just getting out of the college, what will your message be for like all those budding developers or all those budding technologists?
Yeah. So firstly, I would say just know your passion, that whether programming is your bit of taste or not. So firstly, knowing that is very important. So if you know that you can dream code, you can dream the dream. You can dream of your code. So whatever code you are doing, you can see that in your dreams. Then I think that's the one thing. If you are able to see that in your dreams, then morning you can realize that I'm dreaming of my code. So that thing is the one you can think of. Other than that, what I think is just work on your skills. While working on the skill, realize what. I think this is you are the commander of your thinking. So you must realize that how, what thing is important and what thing is not. So like, you can read about the Pareto effect, I guess, 80-20 principle. So yes. Like 20% of the things you can learn, which having 80% of the impact. So you need to figure out very wisely what are those 20% things. Like number could be 20, 25, whatever. So you just need to learn those things first. Just brush up your basics. Start with very basic. If you are novice developer, that I'm starting with very basic, starting with programs, writing a program, writing patterns, writing basic prime numbers programs and other things. Just write that so that you can able to make a command on while, if, and for loops. That is a basic thing. After that, you can advance your things, and going forward, you can go in with the design patterns. Solid principles, that's a bit advanced level. So you can go with that and always try to learn new code and write a code and get reviewed by your code by your mentor or anyone you can rely upon, where you can share your things quite deeply. So just show them their code and get feedback and get them there corrected.
Awesome. That's a wonderful answer. I think a detailed answer, I would say. But there's one thing which came to my mind, and that was, like Manish talked about the dreams part, and there's one thing which I can actually assure everybody of, that once you start coding, it will automatically become the part of your dreams. Either you will have good dreams about it or you will have bad dreams about it, but it will definitely be the part of your dreams. Awesome.
And if it's not coming in your dreams, Rishabh, then I think you are not doing programming correctly.
Yeah, that's so true.
That's the part, yeah.
Great. So guys, this is Manish. Like, we had this wonderful conversation. So Manish, thanks a lot for joining us today. I mean, this was a very valuable conversation. Thanks a lot for sharing your experiences with us. And we really learned a lot out of it.
Pleasure is mine. Thank you.
So this was Manish. I hope you found this video to be useful. And if you think there is somebody else in your network who can benefit from this video, please feel free to share this video. And this is me, Rishabh, signing off. Till the next time. Bye-bye.